This program is brought to you by the Genesis Communications Network, a world leader in talk radio since 1998. Visit GCNlive.com today.
And now, Barb Adams.
Welcome back. You're listening to Barb Adams Live. Thanks so much for joining me for this hour of the show. The Great Pyramid is the only one of the seven wonders of the ancient world still standing. Who were the original builders and how was it built? And what purpose did the Great Pyramid serve? Joining me now to discuss the mystery of the Great Pyramid is author, lecturer, and independent researcher Stephen Myers. Stephen holds a degree in fluid mechanics as an antiquities scholar. He's the author of Lost Technologies of the Great Pyramid and the Great Pyramid Prosperity Machine. In addition, he's the founder of the nonprofit The Pharaoh's Pump, which is dedicated to understanding how and why the Great Pyramid was built. If you'd like lots more information, visit thepump.org. Stephen, welcome back to the show. It's been a while.
It has been a while. Thank you, Barb, for having me on the show.
Yeah,
I really appreciate coming back.
Yeah, well, thanks for joining me tonight, Stephen. First of all, give us a little bit of background on how you came to research the Great Pyramid.
Well, I've always been interested in technology. My education and experience is technology-based. I'm even an amateur radio operator and collect antique gasoline engines for a hobby, which is kind of unusual. But with an interest in, and I'm also interested in history, so with an interest in both history and technology, ultimately a person would direct their focus on the Great Pyramid because it's a 45-story skyscraper built in ancient times and exhibits a lot of very high technology.
In your book, Stephen, you follow along the lines of Edward Kunkel that the Great Pyramid's a water pump. Talk about this a bit.
Yes. Edward Kunkel wrote a book originally in 1963, and it had several editions, and it was called Pharaoh's Pump by Edward Kunkel. Tremendous book. I recommend it to everyone. And his hypothesis was that the Great Pyramid was built using water locks, like in the Erie Canal or the Panama Canal, and that the purpose of the Great Pyramid was that it was infrastructure. And that infrastructure was that it was a functioning machine which pumped water. So, and I'm in effect following in his footsteps and advancing that direction of research to understand how and why the Great Pyramid was built.
So, Stephen, what clues within the pyramid itself lend to this hypothesis that it was a water pump? What have you discovered?
Oh, there's a lot of direct physical evidence that indicates there's a fundamental link between water and the Great Pyramid. Flanders Petrie, an early Egyptologist, discovered what he called Nile earth inside the passages and chambers, which was sediment. And also there was a wall around the Great Pyramid that existed up until the 18th century. And we feel that that wall's purpose was to impound water. Herodotus described the Great Pyramid as being a building, as being like an island surrounded by water. So we think that that wall that I talked about impounded water, and the Great Pyramid was like an island inside that wall. And, of course, Herodotus also said that the Great Pyramid had an artificial duct connected to it. That's in his book, Histories. that he wrote in the 5th century BC, and this artificial duct that he was eyewitness to was either like the input or output of the Great Pyramid water pump. And there's a host of other types of evidence that indicates water certainly was associated with the Great Pyramid.
What about the huge subterranean chamber and the associated tunnels down there? What's been concluded about that? What are your findings and research showing, and what has current Egyptologists saying about that chamber?
Oh, well, Egyptologists pretty much acknowledge that the Great Pyramid doesn't look like a tomb because it has a whole bunch of different passages and chambers. And the pharaoh only had one body, if you will, to intern in there. But so they think that there was a number of changes of plans during construction, that originally this subterranean chamber dug into the solid bedrock was to house the mummy and the treasures. But then there was a change of plans, and then they were going to put those treasures and mummies like in the king's chamber. But we think that the subterranean chamber was built before the Great Pyramid. Most researchers agree on that. But its odd construction indicates that it was used to pump water, similar, although different, than a hydraulic ram water pump. But that's a similar type of pump. And water went down the descending passage, and then ultimately that pump was used to supply the water to the water locks during construction.
And when you're talking about the building of the Great Pyramid, Stephen, with these water locks, what evidence remains about those locks at this time?
Well, we think those water locks existed in the casing stones, if you will. They were incorporated into the casing stones, and the casing stones themselves had been removed, as well as the water locks. So there's no working water locks on the Giza Plateau. But again, there's also no big ramp to indicate that it was built using a ramp. Much of the quarries were across the river, and everyone acknowledges that barges were used to move the stones from the quarries across the river to the building site, but none of those barges exist. There's no physical evidence for those barges, but it's just common sense. And a lot of the evidence of the Great Pyramid indicates that water locks were used. One specific piece of evidence is that the casing stones that exist on the Giza Plateau now are bonded together watertight. So that was part of the construction process.
What about Herodotus? What does he have to say about the building of the pyramid itself, as well as is there any indication of the barges or anything in there?
He said that he wrote about his visit to Egypt, and he says that there was a lot of canals in the area. That type of thing. Ancient Egyptians or ancient people in the Valley of the Nile were experts with barges and water transportation. Many of the stones came from a quarry 400 miles upstream. So he said that. He also said that he was told that the Great Pyramid was built level by level. The entire pyramid was built the bottom level, then the next level up, then the next level above that until they got to the top, which was quite interesting. And think that that's correct. Sir Flanders Petrie also felt that the Great Pyramid was built level by level, including the casing stones. So we have a video series on our website, thepump.org, which people can watch the construction process of the Great Pyramid as it was built level by level using water locks and barges. So a lot of this is very visual, this construction process, but if they visit our website and watch that video series, they can get an idea of the process that we think the Great Pyramid was built.
All right, we'll continue this discussion with Stephen Myers on the lost technologies of the Great Pyramid after the break.
America Now presents 2 Minutes with Ken Goldstein.
Barb Adams here, and being rejoined this hour by Ken Goldstein. Ken advises startups and writes the business blog CorporateIntel.us. Ken, we were talking about bibliotherapy. How does it work?
Well, I think it works, in your own mind. You hear the voices of characters. You see the conflicts that they're involved in. You see that the angles that they have to try on, and you see the choices that they make. I think it's impossible to read a great book and to read a well-developed story and not reflect back on your own life, not reflect back on your own emotions, not reflect back on your own motivations, and see how that applies to what you're doing. So I do it all the time. I'm a constant reader. I know, Barb, you're a constant reader. And it's a great way to get lost in someone else's story and then reflect back on your own life and make good choices as a result of that.
So, Ken, can anyone become a bibliotherapist, or is there specific ways of becoming one?
Well, I don't know if you could become a bibliotherapist. I think that you have to know a lot of books and be able to interview people carefully and ask a lot of questions to make a very specific recommendation. But I think we can all use books as a form of self-therapy or self-examination and see ourselves in these characters. So I think in terms of making the recommendation, yes, I think if you're extremely well-read and you really know how to listen to people, you can make great recommendations. But whether you can make recommendations or not, you can participate in it. You can participate in it just by picking up a book, starting to read, and applying it to your own life.
You know, Ken, it sounds like picking up a book and reading one is a great prescription for good health all the way around. All right, we're going to hear more from Ken Goldstein in the next hour.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. I'm here to tell you about GCNTelecare.com, a team of board-certified doctors assisting you 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. Within 15 minutes of registration, care your family can afford. Revolutionizing the healthcare industry, virtual consulting, providing diagnosis of non-emergency medical issues by phone or secure video on computer or smart mobile devices. GCNTelecare.com, virtual care anywhere.
Hi there, I'm Bob Eubanks. You know, as part of Hollywood for a long time, I've seen my fair share of celebrities get in trouble with the IRS. Well, there's one name I trust, the Tax Defense Group. They're the most trusted name in tax. So if you owe more than $10,000 to the IRS, you really need to call my friends at the Tax Defense Group. Ignoring the IRS is not the solution. They can garnish your paycheck, levy your bank accounts, seize your home or business. But the Tax Defense Group could put a stop to all of that and tailor a program that would reduce your tax debt to pennies on the dollar. You gotta love that. So don't just take my word for it. Call them. Find out for yourself. They offer a 100% satisfaction guarantee. And they're open 24 hours a day because they know that tax debt doesn't sleep either.
Call now for your free and confidential tax analysis from the most trusted name in tax. Call 800-361-6907. 800-361-6907.
Did you know there's a new group of water contaminants with unknown health effects? These emerging contaminants lurking in your water may include prescription, over-the-counter drugs, and new types of herbicides and pesticides. ProPure's improved Pro-1 G2.0 filter meets NSF 401 standards to help reduce these emerging contaminants. To find out more, visit your authorized ProPure dealer or ProPureUSA.com. That's ProPureUSA.com.
Thank you for listening to GCN. Visit GCNlive.com today.
Hi, it's John Dowd Jr., author of the book Heroes, Mentors, and Friends. And you're listening to my hero, mentor, and friend, Barb Adams.
All right, everybody. Stephen Myers joining me this hour. We're discussing the lost technologies of the Great Pyramid. And Stephen, you know, you were talking about how the pyramid was probably built level by level. Those stones were very, very heavy, right?
They were very heavy.
And modern Egyptologists tend to still kind of go along the lines, don't they, that, you know, it was a lot of the slaves hauling these things up the ramps and trying to put them together. And yet these stones, the way they were cut and put together so tightly, how does that work when you've got a bunch of people trying to drag these things into place versus the way you're talking about using the lock system?
Well, it's quite interesting about Egyptology. It's amazing that Egyptology does not engage in the scientific method. They have never demonstrated using hand tools to create a single casing stone like those at the Great Pyramid. The casing stones were cut to extreme precision, but Egyptology has never demonstrated their ideas. It's odd. It's really strange. Egyptology has never moved a heavy stone around the corner of a spiral ramp in its entire history of Egyptology. So they do not and will not engage in the scientific method. The heaviest stones of the Great Pyramid are 70 tons. That's about the weight of an Abrams A1 battle tank that they use now. That's about 70 tons. And Egyptologists have never moved a 70-ton payload 1 inch. Isn't that interesting?
Most interesting.
It's like, it's like there was a, if there was a science called cows jump over the moonology, and they talk all about cows jumping over the moon and everything. You know, you can read about it in literature, and there's stories and myths about cows jumping over the moon. But if somebody would say, "Hey, why don't you demonstrate that?" You know, it's the same type of a thing with Egyptology. How they can get away with it, I don't know. It is bizarre, and they don't demonstrate anything. They just pass on these stories, you know, one generation of Egyptology students after another, and they just repeat the same old thing over and over. So who can say? But in the real world, in the Erie Canal, it was built originally 4.5 feet deep, and the barges had a capacity of 70 tons. And also, they had a lot of children working on the Erie Canal. So children could move 70-ton payloads using barges over 100 years ago. But expert Egyptologists, they can't move a 70-ton payload, but they can tell you how it was done all day long.
Yeah, very interesting. Stephen, I know one of the missions of the Pharaoh's Pump, I believe your nonprofit, is not only the understanding, but do you want to actually try to reproduce this?
Yes. Yeah. The foundation that we've started is a 501c3 nonprofit foundation. We're located out here in southwestern Oregon, and we have a headquarters and a research facility here that we are doing experimentation to redevelop the ancient efficient technologies that were used by the original builders to pump water. And it would be an efficient and environmentally clean water pumping system. It would be an alternative to nuclear power or fossil fuels or all of those things. And it would be, you wouldn't need a great big pyramid, but like PVC pipe and polypropylene containers and that type of thing. Scale it down a little bit, of course, and decentralize this water pumping technology and have it built in cottage industries. That's the purpose of our nonprofit foundation, and we're working on that. So one thing we do need that people can help us with is we're doing a crowdfunding effort to acquire a 3D printer, which would help us quite a bit. And you can find out about that at our website at thepump.org. So that we would use that at our facility to further our research. But yes, that is the fundamental purpose of our nonprofit foundation, is to make available this energy efficient alternative water pumping technology.
So let's go back to talking about the pyramid as a pump, Stephen, for just a couple of minutes here. Would this be like a simple ram pump or a hydraulic ram pump, or what in your opinion, what do you hypothesize it was? Was it a ram pump or?
Well, not exactly. A hydraulic ram water pump that is devised by modern mankind requires a drain that has about 80% of the water go through this drain, and it's not pumped at all, and about 20% of the water is pumped. And that's why you don't see hydraulic ram water pumps very often, because they're very inefficient in terms of the water resource. So it's not exactly a hydraulic ram water pump, but it is similar in effect to being like a ram pump, in that there's water moving through the passages and chambers, and chambers and passages that are up in the structure itself, as opposed to the one the chamber below the level of the base of the Great Pyramid, that was a rather complex water pump, but very efficient. And I describe that in great detail in my second book, called The Great Pyramid Prosperity Machine. And this water pump provided prosperity for the builders of the Great Pyramid. If you can have very cheaply and efficiently pumped water, you can use that to generate electricity. And that would be the first and most important purpose in modern times for this ancient high technology.
Okay, I've got a couple of questions along those lines, but we're going to have to hold them there, Stephen. We're going to be heading to another break here. So when we return, we're going to hear more about the lost technologies of the Great Pyramid with Stephen Myers. So stick with us.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX, or my website, danpilla.com.
Are you looking to become more self-sufficient? Then you need to have your own energy source. The Solark EMP hardened generator is automatic, maintenance-free, and reduces your monthly electric bill. You can also take it off-grid when you go camping. Contact PortableSolarLLC.com or call for details at 972-575-8875 today. Portable Solar LLC gives you everything you need to start using solar energy in less than 1 hour. Solark EMP hardened solar generator energy insurance for your family or business. Call Portable Solar LLC today.
Individuals and businesses with tax problems, listen carefully. Do you feel like you're losing control over your finances? If you owe over $10,000 in back taxes or have unfiled tax returns, we can help you take back control. The IRS is the largest and most aggressive collection agency in the world, and they can seize your bank account, garnish your paycheck, close your business, and file criminal charges. Take control of your tax problems now by calling the experts at Tax Mediation Services and take advantage of the Fresh Start Program and new laws that may allow allow us to negotiate a settlement for the lowest amount possible. Our team of tax attorneys and enrolled agents can stop collections and get you protected so you can take control of your financial future. Tax Mediation Services is accredited by the Better Business Bureau. Call now for a free case review and a price protection guaranteed quote.
Call Tax Mediation Services now at 800-615-7709. That's 800-615-7709. 800-615-7709.
Hi, Peter Vaccaro for ParanormalDate.com. Are you looking for love in all the wrong places? Now you have a chance to change that by signing up for free at ParanormalDate.com. This incredible dating site puts people of like minds together. People who are interested in the strange, the unusual, mysteries, ghosts, UFOs, and the afterlife, and so much more. ParanormalDate.com was developed for you, people seeking a viable alternative to the other dating services. You can join for free by going to ParanormalDate.com, and if you decide you like it and want to connect with people, use the code GEORGE for a substantial discount. Mark Rawlings, president of ParanormalDate.com, says so many people hunger to share their experiences about the paranormal, the unexplainable, or the afterlife, and so much more, and this is the source for them to meet and share that common interest. So sign up for free at ParanormalDate.com, ParanormalDate.com, and use the code GEORGE if you decide to connect with someone you like.
Message and data rates may apply.
Hi, I'm Frank Thomas. When I was playing ball, they called me the Big Hurt. But after I left the game, Mother Nature started putting a big hurt on me. I just couldn't stay in shape like I used to. Turns out, it wasn't my fault. Once you hit 40, your body has less free testosterone, and that can make it harder to get into shape. But luckily, I found out about Nugenix.
Nugenix is a unique man-boosting formula powered by Testofen, a patented key ingredient clinically researched to help boost your free testosterone levels. Get a complimentary bottle now by texting PRIME11 to 42424. With Nugenix, you can feel stronger, leaner, with a lot more stamina and energy.
And guys, she'll like the difference too.
Nugenix is GNC's number one selling men's vitality product. Get a complimentary bottle now by texting PRIME11 to 42424. Nugenix samples are not available in stores. So again, text PRIME11 to 42424.
You are listening to GCN. Visit GCNlive.com today.
It's John Dowd Jr., author of the book Heroes, Mentors, and Friends. And you're listening to my hero, mentor, and friend, Barb Adams.
All right, Stephen Myers joining me this hour. We're discussing the Great Pyramid and the ancient technologies associated with it. And Stephen, other than some of the other wild theories out there about how the Great Pyramid was built and what it was used for, yours, you talk about it being a pump. But I've got a question regarding the pump. How did they move the columns of water around? What was the pressure used? How did they create that pressure to move the water around?
Excellent question. We feel that in the Grand Gallery, there were had water in it, and it had electrolysis plates. Those electrolysis plates were energized, and hydrogen and oxygen were separated from the water. The hydrogen and oxygen were combusted to make, believe it or not, this is real, to make a vacuum. Normally, modern mankind uses combustion, like in an engine, to make pressure. But if you have hydrogen and oxygen in a cylinder, you can make a vacuum. And then that vacuum is used to lift a huge column of water, if you will, a huge piston of water up in the Grand Gallery. And then the vacuum was opened. There was a valve that opened, which released the vacuum, and there were several other valves, and that huge water piston moved down and ultimately
moved water into the queen's chamber and compressed the air in the queen's chamber, the upper half of the queen's chamber. And then ultimately the output of the Great Pyramid water pump was the king's chamber vents. And the input was the descending passage. So water traveled through this, those passages and chambers and exited high on the sides of the Great Pyramid out of the king's chamber vents.
So why such a big structure, Stephen? Why did it have to be that big? Because when you look at some of the other pumps that have been made, I'm thinking, it seems like I read something about in Australia about 100 years ago, they did pumps that were built along one of their, I think, Australia's largest river, if I remember right. And they had those types of big cylinders that were bored into the ground, working like pistons to push, to get the pressure enough to force the water out for irrigation. So why a huge pyramid like this?
Yes, that pump you're talking about is called the Humphrey pump in Australia. And they used a large cylinder, if you will, and they created a vacuum to lift a piston of water for irrigation. There's several reasons why the Great Pyramid as a water pump is so big. One is that they didn't use steel like the Humphrey pump. They used steel as opposed to masonry or stone. So for the strength, they needed a large and strong structure, which the Great Pyramid is. And that's one reason. Also, it's large to house those large chambers inside the Great Pyramid. So, but it's certainly not the largest water pump in the world by any means. The hydroelectric dam in central Washington on the Columbia River, the Grand Coulee Dam, it certainly produces electricity, but it's also a self-powered water pump. It pumps enough water to irrigate over 500,000 acres in central Washington. So that's a pretty big water pump here in the United States, and it's about 13 times bigger than the Great Pyramid.
Yes, it is. I've been there. I've seen it. It's huge.
It is huge. You can see there's 9 massive pipes that go up the side of the mountain, and they pump water higher than the dam into the Grand Coulee, which was created in the Ice Age. And that coulee, this huge reservoir, is where Banks Lake is, named after a fellow named Banks, an engineer. And they irrigate much of eastern Washington with this dam. We eat apples that were irrigated using a huge water pump. You know, people don't realize that, but it's very fascinating, tremendous achievement of modern mankind. And a similar achievement in ancient times is this Great Pyramid. It has no ornamentation, doesn't need any hieroglyphs or anything else because it's a functioning machine.
So, Stephen, why several of them then at the Giza Plaza? What were the other pyramids? A lot of people say all the pyramids supposedly, you know, were built around the world with the same causes, you know, for the same reasons. I shouldn't say causes, for the same reasons.
Well, they do. There's people that just say that
yeah.
If it's a pyramid, it's part of some worldwide network or whatever.
Yeah.
But certainly there are 3 large pyramids on the Giza Plateau in Egypt. And other people ask, are the other pyramids pumps? No, they're not pumps at all. They don't have to be, evidently. And myself, I don't even know exactly if they were built by the same culture. Maybe the Great Pyramid was built thousands of years before the other two large pyramids were built. They could have been examples of a Karko cult, if you will, which is during World War II in the Pacific Islands, when
modern soldiers were making bases and everything, the indigenous people kind of worshipped their high technology, and they made airplanes out of palm leaves and that type of thing. It's a cargo cult, if you will, and they got cans of spam and everything else as a blessing or whatever. It's quite an interesting phenomenon, and maybe there's a possibility that some of the other pyramids around the Giza Plateau, there's two big ones and a number of smaller ones, were built as copies or as like a cargo cult or maybe for a religious purpose. But that doesn't mean that the Great Pyramid itself, which has the highest workmanship of any pyramid on Earth, was even associated with these other pyramids, even though they're near each other. But the focus of my research is not whether or not the other pyramids were water pumps, but how the Great Pyramid was built and how it operated as a water pump. And that's fair enough.
Yep, that is. You know, as you mentioned, there are a lot of pyramids all around the world. And some people try to see a correlation between all these pyramids, Stephen. Yeah. there's even Ben Carson weighed in on, you know, what he thinks the pyramids are, well, at least at Giza, the Great Pyramid being a granary. Yes. Yeah, so.
The Great Pyramid enters into presidential politics, but it didn't this year here in the United States.
Yeah.
The idea that the Great Pyramid was a granary was very popular in the 18th and 19th centuries because people compared ancient Egypt with what was written in the Holy Bible. And the Holy Bible talks about granaries in Egypt, you know, with Joseph and all of that. Well, there's big buildings in Egypt, so they made the idea that, oh, they're granaries. Well, they're not very good for granaries because they're pretty much solid. You could put about 2 pickup loads of grain in the Great Pyramid.
Not a whole lot.
Granary.
All right, we'll pick up this conversation on the other side of the break here with Stephen Myers. Stay with us.
Water is the single most important thing your body needs, so you want to be sure it's the best for you and your family. Since 2005, thousands have depended on Berkey purified water. The Berkey guy provides the lowest priced filtration systems in every size. For incredibly delicious water now and in an emergency, get to GoBerkey.com or call 877-886-3653. 877-886-3653. GoBerkey.com.
My computer is so slow, it's making me crazy.
I used to have that problem.
Did you quit using a computer, or did you buy a new one?
Well, I called Geeks On Site. They made an appointment to visit my home and showed up the same day.
You mean they didn't ask you to bring your computer to a shop? That's what happened when I called a support company.
Geeks On Site can go to your home, or business, or even repair your computer online. They have 24/7 emergency service.
If you're having problems with your PC or Mac, call Geeks On Site. 1-800-591-1682. Our friendly certified computer repair experts are available 24/7. Call now for a free diagnosis, 1-800-591-1682. Data recovery, virus removal, and maintenance for all laptops, desktops, printers, and networks. That's Geeks On Site for friendly, certified computer repair experts available 24/7 over the phone or in your home or business. Just call 1-800-591-1682. That's 1-800-591-1682, 1-800-591-1682.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson, Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm of Principal Office in Houston, Texas, is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely on advertisement services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
We use cell phones against our heads every day. But now, a landmark U.S. government study confirms increased health risks from exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The time to protect yourself is now. The solution is Defender Shield. Proudly made in the USA, Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation emitted from cell phones, tablets, and laptops. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. Use discount code DEFENDER for 10% off. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in EMF radiation protection.
What would your life be like if you woke up each morning with new vitality, feeling better than you have in years, and you noticed a difference in your sleeping patterns, blood sugar levels, and had a sense of well-being overall? There's something that is changing thousands of people's lives, and you could be one of them. It's called Heart and Body Extract. Sharon Harris, co-creator of Heart and Body Extract, talks about the positive effects of Heart and Body Extract.
What happens with the formula Heart and Body Extract is it's giving the body the necessary vitamins, minerals, amino acids, enzymes, and phytonutrients so the body will heal itself. And yes, the body does have the ability to balance blood pressure, balance cholesterol, clean and unclog the arteries. It can also work on balancing the circulation for diabetics. So the body is an amazing thing. It simply needs some help so it has the tools to heal itself.
Heart and Body Extract gets results. To order your 2-month supply, call now, toll free at 866-295-5305. Order online at hbextract.com.
Hi, I am Kelly Cook, the Chief Marketing Officer here at Kmart. Did you know that premature birth is the number one killer of babies in the United States, or that survivors can face a lifetime of serious health problems? Guess what? You can help. Join me and Kmart for the March for Babies Walk. We'll work together to raise funds for research and programs that help the March of Dimes fight premature birth and birth defects and improve the health of moms and babies. So start your team today at marchforbabies.org.
Thank you for listening to GCN. Be sure to visit GCNLive.com today.
You're listening to Empowering Talk Radio, right here with Barb Adams.
All right, everybody, welcome back. Talking the Lost Technologies of the Great Pyramid with my guest, Stephen Myers, this hour. Stephen, you know, back in 1983, I think it was, Robert Bovall postulated there's a correlation between the location of the three largest pyramids of the Giza complex and Orion's belt. Thus, the Orion Correlation Theory came about. What are your thoughts on this?
Well, it's rather interesting, to be sure, the idea that the position of the pyramid somehow had some significance with the position of these stars, and that's wonderful to think that. But if you have a correlation between two things, doesn't matter what they are, there needs to be a separate piece of evidence that indicates that correlation was intended. There's a saying in legitimate academic research that a correlation doesn't even imply a causation. And just because something like points to something for some reason or whatever, then people have certainly jumped on the bandwagon of all of these star correlations and that type of thing. But there's specific to the Great Pyramid, there's no feature or no evidence, let me put it that way, that indicates that the original builders intended any symbolic purpose for the Great Pyramid at all. But people perceive these correlations and give them significance. And not to dwell on it, but that has happened before in the 19th century with a way to study the Great Pyramid called pyramidology, which is to compare, instead of the Great Pyramid with the stars, you compare the Great Pyramid with the Holy Bible. And they have hundreds and hundreds of correlations using the pyramid inch that they've come up with and all of these like the Bethlehem angle where Jesus was born and the Great Pyramid is prophecy in stone. And that's fine to come up with all of these precise correlations, but without any causation to indicate that they were intended, then it is not legitimate academic research to do that type of thing.
Yeah, basically, it's a logical fallacy, correct?
I think it is. And correlation theories, they come and they go, and they get really popular. There was a science called phrenology, which was the study of the correlations between bumps on people's heads and character traits, okay? And that was taught in universities about the phrenology and everything else. But there was a problem. There was no causation that validated those correlations. It could not withstand the rigors of the scientific method, and phrenology went away. It's gone. It's just it's in the ash heap of forgotten ideas. And the biblical correlation theory has done the same thing. People come up with all these correlations, but people say they reject that because it's just stuff that people make up. And I think even though the Orion correlation theory or whatever you want to call it is very popular, I think it will follow the same path as other correlation theories. And people now say, well, what validates all these correlations? And you can't get a straight answer about people, just believing these correlations. So it's interesting what mindset people have. So, and another thing about all these correlation theories, you ask them, well, you have these correlation theories, how was the Great Pyramid built? And they can't even, address that. They consider the Great Pyramid as a pre-existent artifact to be understood symbolically, but there's no feature of the Great Pyramid that indicates it was intended to be a symbolic structure.
Right. And with the Orion correlation, I believe as many astronomers have shown that at the time that the pyramid was built, there wouldn't have even been a perfect match between the pyramids and the Orion's belt. And I believe the correlation theory also speculates or hypothesizes, that the Sphinx was representative of Leo, and yet at the time, the Sphinx would have been on the other side of the Nile if that was true. So it's all very interesting, as you say.
It is. It's very muddled. It's almost like a denomination of a correlation cult, if you will. Do you want to believe the biblical correlation theory or a different denomination, the Orion correlation theory? And they talk about the vents pointing to certain stars. You see pictures of that all over the internet and everything.
Yep.
Well, because of the precession of the equinoxes, or the grand precession, if you want to call it that, those vents don't point to those stars. They don't point to the stars. So do you interpret that as saying, well, the correlation was temporary, and now it's null and void?
Hmm.
Or do you interpret it as, well, the stars that they actually point to now, they're the stars that they were intended to point to because they actually point to them. And it's all, it's circular reasoning.
Yeah.
It's logical fallacies built upon supposition and conjecture. It's going to lose its popularity, let me put it that way.
The only thing we do know is that in statistics, correlation does not imply causation, period.
You are correct. Yeah, and I've argued with a few people about that, but you are very wise.
Yeah, on that one. But if people want to get more information about all of this, Stephen, and about your books and about the Pharaoh's Pump, where can they find the books and more information about you and the Pharaoh's Pump?
Well, hopefully they can go to our website at thepump.org, and find out what we're about. They can contact us through email. They can like us on Facebook or in LinkedIn. We're involved in that. We have a YouTube channel that they can get to from our website. So our books are available on Amazon.com in softcover or Kindle ebook. We also have a DVD documentary about how the Great Pyramid was built on Amazon. And our current main project here at the Foundation is our second DVD documentary about how the Great Pyramid operated as a water pump, because, again, it's very visual. A lot of processes are going on inside the Great Pyramid. So that is our upcoming project, and it will be done in a few months, maybe 3 or 4 months. And but again, I hope people get involved in what we're doing. Look at our website, contact us with any questions, and we will try to answer any questions they have.
You know, on your website, the Pharaoh's Pump, you state that on the pump.org, excuse me, you state that an accurate and true understanding of the Great Pyramid will give a wonderful vision of the future. What do you mean by that?
Well, there was a time when there wasn't a Great Pyramid, and people invested hugely to build a Great Pyramid for their future because the Great Pyramid had a huge return on investment. It wasn't built at a big cost, but it was a wise investment for their future. And if we can have an alternative to all of these environmentally damaging energy technologies that we have, then it would make our society, our civilization, our future safer, and it will make it freer. If we don't have a huge electric bill to pay every month, it will decentralize energy production. It will stop the transfer of wealth from the first world to the third world by buying their oil, if you will. It will keep the environment cleaner if we can redevelop this ancient technology that the original builders had in ancient times.
Stephen, thank you for joining me this evening. Really appreciate it. All right, everybody, stay tuned. There's more to come here on Barb Adams Live after the break.
Attention investors, 2017 is the year of Trump, and financial markets are rising at all-time highs. But economic uncertainty may be greater than after any election in our lifetime. And as retirement approaches, there's little time to recover your losses. You need to hedge against uncertainty. That means transferring part of your retirement to physical gold and silver stored where you can actually hold it in your hand and get it fast in any disaster. It's a perfect time to buy. Prices are low and expected to climb. Make Augusta Precious Metals your personal gold and silver provider. Augusta cares for your financial position and helps you make good decisions. And they're A-plus rated by the Better Business Bureau. Get Augusta's free gold and silver IRA guide. What you learn could help you weather any economic storm. There's no obligation. Just call toll-free. Call 855-222-5857. That's 855-222-5857. Again, 855-222-5857. Trust Augusta. Protect your retirement today.
The answer to being in control of your own health care is freedom from insurance. Become part of a group of self-pay patients that come together to share in each other's medical expenses. Individual share amounts begin at $107 a month and $347 for families. Choose from three health sharing programs. Holistic treatments may be eligible for sharing. See guidelines. Discount programs available for dental, vision, and pharmacy. Go to libertyoncall.org. That's libertyoncall.org.
Are you one of the 70% of Americans that want to own your own business, afraid to leave the security of your current job to pursue your dreams? I'm Pharmacist Keith. Dr. Wallach, the Dead Doctors Don't Lie guy, and myself want to show you a low-cost way to create your own business, working around your current job schedule, creating extra income for you and your family by joining his crusade, spreading his message of better health. To learn more, visit radio.recordedvideo.com, radio.recordedvideo.com. That's radio.recordedvideo.com.